Hey, good evening, and welcome here to the campus of Montana Tech as we get ready for the first round of the men's NAIA National Tournament. Thanks for joining us here on Digger Vision. Paul Panisco, John Thatcher joining me here shortly as we get ready for the first round action as the Warriors of Lewis Clark States, at-large bid out of the Cascade Conference, getting ready to take on Hope International out of California as they come in as an at-large out of the GSAC. Both of these two programs really good years. Hope International, 21-9 on the year, 9-5 in the GSAC. On the other side for the Warriors, 22-8 on the year, and 19-3 in the Cascade Conference. So again, thanks for joining us as we make our way through a Friday night here in Butte, Montana. First round of the men's NAIA National Tournament. We have two games tonight. This game right now, Montana Tech will take on Wayland Baptist coming up next at 7 p.m. We'll have that for you as well here on Digger Vision. And then tomorrow, the winners will play at 6 p.m. Mountain Time, and the winner of that ball game will head off to Kansas City with 15 other programs. John Thatcher, how are you?
That's the object. Get to the other 15 programs and beat all of them.
How exciting is this?
Well, it's exciting for a lot of people. I've been to this stuff before, so it's just another game, but it's an important game for everybody.
Yes, indeed. As the Warriors getting ready to take on Hope International, the fun part about these two teams, they've already met. These two teams played earlier this year. Hope International winning that one in Caldwell, Idaho, at a tournament, which might as well have been, you know, 3 years ago in November. Certainly, teams change a whole lot in that span. But again, you do at least have an idea what their roster holds, and you have something to kind of prepare for in a game like this.
Yeah, and that game was won in the last 2 seconds on a three-point shot, but reality is teams are not playing their best in November. They're playing their best now, or they wouldn't be here.
Exactly. And
so throw out the record books. This one's going to be a defensive battle as far as I can see. Both teams averaging about 77 points a game, but for some reason, Hope has a little notch up on their defensive end of the court, plus they're an extremely good shooting team.
Yeah, they have a couple things that they do really, really well. And the first one that jumps off the page is free throws for me. They led the GSAC in free throw attempts, free throws made, and free throw percentage, and their free throws made was number 3 in the country. I think they had like 513 points from the foul line this year.
Yes. 78%.
Yeah, you'll take that.
I coach down there. Then I coach their free throw shooters.
Well, we're going to check in with head coach Sheck from Hope International in just a moment. Let's take a break. We're back after this 1 minute timeout.
Now's the time to get into Butte Auto and custom build your own ride just the way you want it. Choose from 9 brands and compare them all at one location. Don't wait. Take advantage of our VIP appointment or stay where you are and shop easily from ButteAuto.com. At Butte Auto, we believe in exceptional service and an easy buying process. Easy buying process. Contact one of our 4 dealerships and custom build your next ride at Butte Auto today.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech as we get ready for the first round of the NAIA National Tournament. Coach Sheck here from Hope International. First off, Coach, congratulations on getting the bid, getting here, and getting ready to roll in round one.
Thank you so much. We appreciate it. We feel very fortunate to be here.
Talk about the travels to Butte. Everything okay? You ready to roll?
Yeah, we had a nice trip up. First time a lot of us have been to Montana, and it's absolutely beautiful up here. It's really gorgeous. We love it.
Well, yeah. we're thrilled to have you here, and this is something I've looked forward to for a long time. These first round games, some of my favorite basketball in the country. Talk about what Hope International does well coming into this game.
Well, we're a team-oriented team. I mean, everything revolves around the brotherhood of being together. Defensively is usually our strength. And, we like to move the ball on offense and try and get everybody involved.
It feels like if we had a calling card for the four teams here, it's all about defense. It feels like everybody that is here in the gym this weekend really likes to push the pace on the defensive side of things.
Yeah, it's interesting how that works out when it gets to the playoff time, right? The four teams that are here, everybody's emphasizing defense. So the further the pyramid goes, the more defense is a priority, and that wins you games.
You've obviously seen Lewis Clark State earlier this year at Caldwell, Idaho. That thing might as well have been 3 years ago, though. You look back to November, and a whole lot has changed since then. Do you analyze that November game much, or do you just kind of put it away and just get ready?
We definitely do. I mean, just looking at their tendencies and the way the coach utilizes his guys and the plays they run and stuff like that. So that stuff helps. Obviously, the personnel has changed a little bit in the minutes that guys are getting, and he's had a lot of guys step up that got an opportunity, and they took advantage of it.
Well, Coach, we wish you the best of luck, and thank you so much for joining us.
Have a great night.
Appreciate it.
Thanks for having us.
Ladies and gentlemen, first round of the NAIA tournament, getting ready to roll. Hope International take it on Lewis and Clark. So we'll take a break. We'll check in with Lewis and Clark coaching staff in just a moment.
We really wanted to expand our menu, really wanted to expand our clientele, offer the full bar, offer the grill and pub menu. I think everybody at First Montana did a really good job just walking us through it and explaining everything. Ryan really helps us by asking us personal questions. It makes a personal investment in what we're doing here. I think that matters more than just about anything, really. The personal relationship that you have and the personal attention that you get.
First Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Hey, welcome back here once again as we are on the campus of Montana Tech, the first round of the NAIA National Tournament. Montana Tech hosting for the second year in a row as the Warriors of Lewis Clark State getting ready to take on Hope International. Good chat there with Coach Sheck from Hope International. And then the other side of the coin, we have Lewis Clark State, a team that you and I are, we're obviously Tech guys, but we are Frontier Conference fans. On a personal level and on a conference level, we owe Lewis and Clark State and Westminster University out of Salt Lake City a whole lot for the success and the power that the Frontier Conference currently has.
No question. They and the College of Idaho forced this conference to recruit better and make it a better. They were winning it every single year they were in it. And they have just they've transformed this league, and that's been since Kelvin Sampson left. But it transformed the whole look of this league. You see better athletes. Probably not much better, but a lot more of them than you saw back then.
You know, Lewis Clark State was in the conference for 22 years. They won the Frontier Conference regular season crown 8 of those years, and they won the tournament 9 of those 22 years. So, again, needless to say, Lewis Clark State is a team and a program that we know well, a team that we are rather fond of, and certainly everybody down to Lewiston, thanks for joining us as a doubleheader down there. Their women are playing immediately after this, so Brian Danner will have that for you in the Lewiston area. So thanks for joining us here on Digger Vision as the Warriors take it on the Royals. The Warriors come in. They're a team we saw earlier this year. They played Montana Tech and Western on this floor. They're certainly very familiar, if you will, with the Frontier Conference, with the drive here, with playing here as well. How much of an advantage is that when you kind of have that in your back pocket, playing on this floor a couple times already when you take on a team like Hope International?
Well, I think it helps. I think they learn to get acclimated to the 6,000 feet, first of all.
That's it.
And they understand that. The interesting thing you told me, they only brought 9 players with them. Is that correct?
Their bench is thin.
Sometimes you need more than 9 when you're coming up playing this out. And it doesn't show its face until about the middle of the second half, and that's when you can tell when players start grabbing the bottom of their trousers and putting their hands down and holding their legs. And so we'll see late in the game if it bothers Hope or if it bothers Lewis and Clark.
Well, let's dig into your coaching years. If you're Coach Sheck from Hope International, you look across and only see 9 guys on the bench. Are you going to try and exploit that? Are you really going to try and put the pedal to the floor and get them gassed in a game like this? Or how do you approach it at all? Is it a factor?
Well, it's got to be a factor. I don't know who didn't come. I mean, 10 players or 8 players didn't come. So I don't know. Are any of them starters or any of them keys off the bench? I don't know. I would know if I was a head coach over here. I'll guarantee you that. But, yeah, you probably can push the ball a little bit. I don't know the strength of their bench. It can't be really overly strong. And I always compare everybody's right now to Montana Tech because they're 5, 6, 7 deep coming off that bench.
Yeah.
So it could be a factor. I don't think so. It's a game of basketball. If your starters got to play a little longer than you're used to, then so be it.
The other side that does help them is with the NAIA rules. We are used to doing, here in the Frontier Conference, we do 2 media timeouts. And during the NAIA tournament, we have 3 media timeouts. So that certainly could help in the long run. For windage for both teams, is obviously elevation, like you say, is going to be an issue today, but really going to be an issue tomorrow.
No question about it. No question about it at all. It's funny. All the things that you think about as a coach, you don't worry about once the players are put out on the floor and you get them started. And you know what? They're young men. They're 18, 19, 20, 21, 22 years old. They can handle this. They're in great shape. It's the end of basketball season. So you can either, as a coach, overthink things or you can just go out and play the game that you're capable of.
Well, again, thanks for joining us here on Digger Vision as we make our way through this just a lovely day here in the Mining City of Friday in Butte. We have 2 games today, 1 game tomorrow, and we'll find out who the teams are that are going to go to Kansas City as we take a look at both these teams. As we look at Hope International, as we mentioned earlier, Hope comes in with an at-large bid. They're 21-9 on the year. They finished 6-8. An at-large bid coming out of the GSAC. They're 6-8 at the national tournament as they have been here 10 times in their program's history and back-to-back years for Hope International getting to the national tournament. On the other side, for Lewis Clark State, they have been to the dance 18 times in school history. They missed out on the opportunity last year, but were there in 2022. The Warriors are 10-16 here at the national dance. So an awfully good record. A lot of wins stacked up there for both these programs here at this level.
A lot of wins, but if you notice, both of them have losing records. Guess what? Most teams do.
I was going to say, there aren't many that don't.
I know. People will hear that record and go, well, that's not that great. Well, no. They went to the Nationals. They won 10 times. Yeah, they've lost 16, but they played some pretty good teams.
Well, and that's something, I mean, you can attest to, and better than most, that idea of how hard it is to win games at this level. It's a big deal in a program's history to get their first win at the national tournament, and then you just start trying to build off of that first win because very few programs are going to get a win in their first time at the dance.
Yeah, and that creates culture and creates expectations. You expect to win now. Once you've won the World Series, like my favorite New York Yankees always do.
Who?
But they haven't in the last 20 years.
Who?
Yeah, once you win that, people expect it all the time. And your athletes expect it, as they should.
Well, again, thanks for joining us as we get ready for game number 1 here at the NAIA National Tournament. Round 1 tonight, Lewis Clark State taking on Hope International. And then Montana Tech doing battle with Wayland Baptist University. Paul Panisco, John Thatcher here. We're making our way through the pregame. We'll take a look at your starters in a bit, but let's take a break here from our sponsors. We're back here to the Hyper right after this 1-minute timeout.
Trident 5550, the Case IH combination application system solution. A couple of key points for model year 2024 are going to be the addition of 135-foot spray boom for that enhanced productivity, and then AIM Command Flex 2, the ultimate in advanced spray technology, individual on-off nozzle control, a host of other features, making the most of your product application. To learn more, visit your Case IH distributor or caseih.com.
Hey, welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech as the Warriors out of Lewis-Clark State taking on Hope International. Again, Hope International 21-9 on the year. They went 9-5 in the GSAC. LC State plays in the Cascade where, you know, they don't get many non-conference games, honestly, in the GSAC. With 12 teams, they play everybody twice, home and away. That eats up 22 of your games. And we were lucky enough to see LC here twice earlier this year. They took on Western, took on Montana Tech. And, you know, so we've got a little bit under our belt here with the Warriors anyway.
Well, you know, it's better than the Frontier Conference having to play everybody three times during the season and then having to go play them in a tournament. Because it's almost impossible to beat somebody four times. It's really tough to beat them three times, but four times is a joke. So hopefully we get some people, we expand this conference, and we can have a normal activity on the schedule.
Well, as we get ready to roll here, obviously we talk about the national tournaments and it changes things. Obviously, as a coach, talk about how you prepare guys for a game like this, because obviously you're going to sit there and tell them it's just another game, it's just another game, it's just another game, but it's not. It's the national tournament. How do you get your guys prepared, get them ready for that opening tip-off in the first 10 minutes?
Well, first of all, you don't tell them it's just another game. This is our season. That's what you tell them. Okay. This is what we play for. This is why we're out here. This is why we're going out there. This is the ones we want to win. Our ultimate goal is the gold ring. It's to win the national championship. We can't do that if we don't. And let's don't think about the second game. Let's think about our first game and walk through that thing. Well, so you never indicate to a player that let's look down the road. You never look down the road, ever. Yeah. I can tell you, I looked down the road when I was young. I looked back up the road because I got my rear end kicked.
From a player and even, again, another coaching perspective, we have two games tonight. Would you rather be in this first game or would you rather be in the second game and obviously seeing what's happening on the floor, things like that? Do you have a preference?
No, it doesn't matter. To me, it wouldn't matter because you don't play till 6 o'clock tomorrow. You're going to have all the film you want to study. He's going to be up at 6 a.m. He's going to be in that film room. He's going to be breaking it down. His kids are probably going to have to come in. He probably let them sleep. Maybe, I don't know, Coach Hyatt's kind of tough. But then they're going to come and watch it, and they're going to break it down. They're going to be ready for the next game.
Well, again, thanks for joining us here on Digger Vision. Game one of round one of the NAIA National Tournament. Paul Panisco, John Thatcher. The Royals out of Hope International, they are led by Gavin Ramirez. He's a 6'7" senior, wears number 25. He averages 14 points a game. Tristan Williams, a junior, a 6'7" junior inside, averages 11 points a game. Grant C., a 5'11" junior, hits 13 points a game for Hope International coming in. Three players in double digits. On the other side for Lewis-Clark State, as we mentioned, nine players on the roster coming in. Jaden Bradley was a newcomer of the year in Cascade Conference play, 15 points a game for him. Alton Hamilton at 11 points a game. He's a freshman of the year in the Cascade Conference. Davian Brown gets 13 and Quentin Rayner gets 11 points a game for Lewis-Clark State. You see their starters there on your screen as these guys get ready to roll. And yes, that Stockton name for those not in the LC area, he is in the building.
Yes, he is. And I went up and talked to him. I did.
I know.
Yeah, you got to get to know people.
There you go. So, again, thanks for joining us here as the Royals getting warmed up. This is exciting. These two teams coming in. And, again, we are in the Naismith quadrant, that side of the bracket. We'll talk about that as we continue. We'll try and keep you updated on other scores, not only, throughout our area, but throughout the country. We'll get our starting lineups again in detail here in a moment. And we're officially about ready to roll, JT. What's important for the Royals out of Hope International to get started early?
Well, you got to be real calm coming out. I don't think you can get overly excited. You don't want to put yourself in a spot where you're down 10, 12, 14 points early in the game. So you got to maintain your composure throughout from the get-go. Yeah, every human being's different about that. And in particular, their guard play, their point guard especially, has to be under control and keep his team under control. You don't want to dig a grave.
On the other side, quickly for Lewis-Clark State, what do they need to get rolling early?
I think they got to be a little more patient with the basketball. I think both teams push it, but you're going to face a team that I think, based on everything I've read, Hope International is really solid on defense. They get a lot of steals. They get to the free throw line a ton. A lot of that has to do with steals. So I think they got to show a lot of patience and run their stuff. Both teams are going to get up and down the floor, but you better run your offense and run it correctly.
Well, we're about to get our national anthem. So with that, we will pause. Ladies and gentlemen, we're back here after the national anthem in this two-minute timeout.
It's more of a business anymore than it is riding. I'm booking, you know, travel, I'm booking athletes, large contracts, insurance, all kinds of different things. Ryan Nielsen, it doesn't get any better. I'm traveling busy all the time, and he'll help with all kinds of different things, from being in touch with my accountant to help finance some of the stuff that I need to get everything taken care of. The relationship there is, it's absolutely amazing.
First, Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Hey, welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech as we get ready for the first round of the men's NAIA National Tournament. We have the Warriors starters getting introduced as we speak. If we got our gentlemen in the back, you want to throw those up? Thanks, boys. Jaden Bradley, Davian Brown, Alton Hamilton, John Lustig, and Sam Stockton. Your starting five for the Warriors here today out of Lewis Clark State. Once again, 22-8 on the year, 19-3 in the Cascade Conference. Let's swap it over to the Royals, shall we, out of Hope International. Hope International, 21-9 on the year, 9-5 at the GSAC this year. As you take a look at their starting five there, Gavin Ramirez will be getting the starting nod. Also, Tristan Williams, Giselle Carter Jr. starting, along with Grant C. and Jalen Shores for the Royals. As I mentioned earlier, Grant C., 13 points a game. Gavin Ramirez at 14 a game for Hope International. And Tristan Williams gets himself 11 for the Royals.
Balanced scoring.
That is the deal.
You know, usually you got teams come in, you got at least one player to average between 18 and 22 a game. Neither one of these teams have one.
So let's get this thing ready to roll. The Royals taking on the Warriors here on Digger Vision. Thanks for joining us throughout the country here. First round of the NAIA National Tournament. We have game two coming up after this as well, as Montana Tech will take on Wayland Baptist. The first time ever that the Ore Diggers and Wayland Baptist have ever played.
I didn't know. I thought they played each other this year.
Nada. Nope. Not this year. And, well, never. So there, you're welcome. Just
Thank
a bit
you.
Of history for you, brother.
Well, good. I'll remember that.
So the
Warriors tomorrow.
The Warriors wearing the road blue, and the Royals wearing the home white. The Warriors come in the number 11 seed. Hope International, the number 6 seed here in the Naismith Quadrant. And we're about ready to go here. As the Warriors, ball goes in the air, and we are underway. So into the offensive side we go. I think I lost power over here for a moment. Warriors, pass goes out on the left side, little ball fake, looking up toward the top of the horn. Pass hands off there to Lustig. Lustig moving left, around a screen, drips down to the corner. Comes up top there to Stockton. Sam Stockton backs out. He's going to set up the offense, switches to his left hand, into the paint. Stockton loses his defender and floats it in. Nice take by Sam Stockton. He rolls in the first basket, and we're underway.
Do you think it's automatic if your name's Stockton, you got to be a point guard? I think it is.
And you'd better be able to dribble.
And you better be good at it. Yeah, for sure.
So here we go back the other way. Royals driving. That's a great take to the basket by Gavin Ramirez. Strong.
One dribble and to the hoop.
2-2 our score. Warriors into the offensive side. Warriors hand off left side. Lustig. Lustig looking into the high post. Rolls it up top. Double team coming. Boy, quick defensive work. Now we're going to get a whistle and a jump ball call. That was quick hands that time by Jalen Shores.
Yeah, that was the thing. Hope International really is really sound defensively, and that's the thing I think. That's why LC's got to take better care of the basketball.
So the Royals with it. Step back. Pass comes up top there. Now on the wing, handoff goes to Ramirez. Ramirez drops it off in the corner, gets it back on the baseline. 12 feet out, Ramirez drives, passes to the right elbow. Jump shot is up and in. Nice take by Grant C. So C gets his first field goal. He averages 13 a game. And the Royals up 4-2. LC into the offensive side, bobbled out there on that left side by Brown for a moment. Brown comes to Stockton. Stockton to the right wing, picks up his dribble, feeds it into the paint. Spin move, double team, ball stripped out, travel call.
Excellent defensive play. That's two times. They tied him up first time, and actually the official could have called a tie up on that. That is a great defensive play.
Yeah, Hamilton went to lean into his defender, and they pulled the chair out from under him. On top of it, great defensive play. Again, these two teams met earlier this year back in November in Caldwell, Idaho at the College of Idaho, and the Royals won it by 3. Scoop shot no good. Offensive rebound back up to Ramirez. Ramirez moves it around the arc down to the bottom right corner to C. C to the right wing. Back to C. Outside the arc with the left hand, drives into the paint. C, bounce pass to the corner. Long range 3. That one's going to go long. Another offensive board. Now the pass stolen by Stockton. Stockton's going to come out of the pile through into the double team, and we're going to get a whistle and a foul. So a whistle and a foul here. And the personal foul is going to be charged to the Royals as Grant C. picks up the personal. LC will inbound to Lustig. Lustig's pass picked off. Big-time play, Ramirez. Coast to coast, up off the glass, no good as Tristan Williams took it to the hole.
Yeah, he was going to dunk it and had a neighbor show up and forced him to shoot high on the glass. Must have got him.
Lustig will pick up the personal foul, and that will put Tristan Williams at the line.
So we got two turnovers here back-to-back. We had a tie-up that gave him the ball. This defense is creating problems for Lewis and Clark.
At the line, Tristan Williams, again, averages 11 a game. And his first free throw attempt is up and in. So the Royals leading 5-2 over the Warriors. Again, thanks for joining us here on Digger Vision. First round of the NAIA National Tournament. Montana Tech hosting in back-to-back years. They hosted and won their quadrants a year ago. Williams goes 2-2 from the line. Stockton down the floor here for the Warriors. Pass goes wide left to Bradley. Bradley into the offensive zone. He'll move it down to Rayner. Rayner puts up 11 a game for the Warriors. Now it comes up top to Bradley. Bradley, newcomer of the year in the Cascade Conference. Drifts down to the bottom right corner. And now it comes out, three-point shot is on the way and off the iron, no good that time for Quentin Rayner.
Hope University does a great job of playing the seams, but where they're making it tough on LC is they're keeping the ball on one half the floor. They're not allowing that reverse pass, and it's awesome to watch.
Royals into the offensive side. Pull up, pass goes wide left. C with the ball fake. C wants the baseline. Brings his defender off his feet. Out on the left side. Jump shot is on the way. Rims out. Big defensive rebound coming out. Well, that one's going to be Brown. So here we come quickly into the offensive side. Warriors with it. Warriors cross-court pass. Three-point shot is on the way. Front of the rim. No good for Brown. And here come the Royals the other way. LC trying to get something going. Now we're going to get an offensive.
That, and he took a shot on that. That was taking a charge.
As Davian Brown goes sliding about 10 feet across the floor, and that will be Warrior basketball. Coach Johnson barks out the play, and here come the Warriors back the other way, trailing by 4. They've had some looks, just have been unable to get it down. Stockton drives all the way. Wraparound pass anticipated and stolen. Royals the other way. Transition Shores. He'll fire from the right elbow. No good. Long offensive rebound. Ramirez had it. It's knocked out. Players diving for it. And now we're going to get a jump ball. It's either that or a two-point reversal.
Boy, these two teams are playing hard.
Love it. So the Warriors will have it on the possession arrow. Anything of note here in the first couple minutes?
Still filling each other out. Lewis Clark's got to take care of the basketball a little better.
Into the offensive side, Stockton. Passes wide left, long range three. That one hits the iron, comes out no good. And on the rebound, we're going to get a whistle and a foul on the baseline. And that's going to be a shove call underneath on Williams. Tristan Williams was on the baseline. I saw him down there, but I did not see the call. Do you have eyes on it at all?
I did not.
So Tristan Williams called with the shove, so the Warriors will remain in possession of the basketball. About 4 minutes gone. That one's swatted out of bounds. Remains Warrior basketball.
Did I ever tell you the game's about quickness? Well, he was so beat. That is quick.
Man. I love when we get a look at other conferences in other parts of the country, you know? Inbound, driving into the paint. Ball stripped away again. Huge play by Jalen Shores. He'll back up, set up the offense. Shores is incredibly fast. Pass goes left to Ramirez. He'll move it across right side to C. C lost the dribble for a minute. Throws it out right side to Williams. Williams enters into the high post. Great pass out to C. Ball fake. C, 12 feet away, lobs it all the way down to the baseline. As he goes down there, as Williams to C. C, collision at the top of the horn, and we're going to get a block call. Whoa, a little physical, JT.
That's how the game's supposed to be played.
I love it. I look over at you, and you're just studying this thing. This is
I am. I guess
like a
the
chess
breaking
match so far.
LC's turned the ball over four times. If you call that tie-up a turnover, which I do, I don't know how the statistics do, but Hope is not taking advantage of that.
Hope International backing up, looking to set it up as C. C looking left. He'll drop it off there to Carter. Carter feeds it on the interior to Williams. Williams right side, jump shot is up and out, no good. And here come the Warriors in transition quickly as Boykins. Boykins goes to the left hand.
Great transition defense by both teams.
Bradley right side, three-point shot. That one goes long for Rayner. Offensive rebound by the Warriors. And they'll set up a long range three. That one no good again. Jaden Bradley fired. The Warriors are 0-for from downtown so far here in the first half.
Yeah, I don't think either team's a great three-point shooting team.
So the Royals. Pass goes into the paint. Turnaround jump shot is up and out. No good. We get something situated here. As the Warriors going to run four wide. Inside. That's a big-time play, JT.
They just needed a high-percentage shot, and a dunk will usually do it.
That usually does it. So here comes the Royals back into the offensive side. Try and get something situated here. As pass on the right wing, feeds it to right elbow to Williams. Outside three-point shot is up and in. Big-time shot. Knocking that one down is Giselle Carter Jr.
My numbers are right. I think they only shot 31% from the three during the season. Acceptable to by a lot of coaches. I'm not one of them.
One sec here. So the Warriors looking to set things up up top. Driving through the paint. Nice take to the basket with a right-hand shot. Won't go for Bradley. Had everything he wanted but the points that time.
I think he turned an ankle.
Okay. Yep. Royals player is injured, and that's a big one. As Gavin Ramirez rolls an ankle, their leading scorer will go to the bench, and we'll see how long he is going to stay there. 13:32 left to play here in the first half. We have a timeout on the floor, so we'll take one as well. Ladies and gentlemen, we're back to the Hyper after this one-minute timeout. Hey, we're back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. First round of the NAIA National Tournament. As the Royals inbounding, they lead 9-4. Neither team lighting it up on the offensive side, but I would dictate that more to a little defense than lack of shooting on the other side.
Yeah, the teams are both outstanding defensive teams.
Through the middle, pass goes left, Simu. As Sage Siamu is into the ball game, seeing his first minutes here today. Little switch dribble, driving into the paints, pick it up. Pass goes out to Williams. Williams, good defense by the Warriors. Shot clock at one. Forced to fire it up at the buzzer, no good. And that one goes to the ground. Warriors will grab the rebound. Great defensive stand. Warriors into the offensive side for wide. Up top with it, Brown. Brown's going to fire. Three ball is money.
Pretty step back.
Davian Brown is the one I was told. As far as a shooter goes, you have to watch. This young man can knock it down. He made that one look awfully easy. The Warriors within two, 9-7.
Created big separation with that step back.
12:40 left to play here in the first half. As the Royals up by two, they have the ball. Down the left side of the paint, spin. Pass comes out to Williams. Williams, long range three, comes up short. Big rebound by Gordon Boykins. Boykins quickly in transition. Pass down to the corner, gets the top of the horn. Moves it around right side. Three-point shot, no good for Rayner. So Rayner will miss that. Here come the Royals in transition. Quickly all the way to the baseline, and a travel call going to go on Cameron DeShiel. So DeShiel called with the walk.
What did I do, he says.
Yep.
Question mark. Whatever that guy with the whistle tells you, you did.
Well, that's something you have to take into account. Obviously, things are going to be officiated differently in different regions of the states and in different conferences. And that's part of this as well, is kind of learning those tendencies.
Well, and that's what you always tell your players when you're coaching.
Quentin Rayner with the three, no good.
You got to go by what's going on, figure the ref out, too.
Royals into the offensive side. Faking the pass, ball knocked away, but that one's going to go out of play. Remains Royal basketball. Good defensive pressure that time, and honestly kind of heads up by the Royals not to track that down in trouble. They just let it go out of bounds. 11:50 left to play here in the first half. Royals lead by two, 9-7. The inbound pass to Shores. Shores looking to his left, passes that way to C. Grant C to Williams. Williams comes all the way up top now. Has Carter with it. Carter back to C. C around a screen, little stutter step, wanted the cut, well defended. Williams steps, fires, wide right. And that's another one. He was forced to throw it up. The shot clock was down to one. And here come the Warriors in transition. The Warriors' defense really has buckled down here over the last 5 minutes. Warriors' chance to tie it up, possibly take the lead. That pass intercepted, loose, picked up. Here's Carter with a right hand, easy two.
That's what I expect to see out of Hope, getting out in those passing lanes. That's a great defensive play.
Warriors, pass goes left, now down in the corner to Lustig. Lustig, his pass is tipped, almost taken. Stockton holding on to it. Stockton top of the horn, around a screen, hands it off in the corner, gets it back. Stockton, little switch dribble. Down inside to Brown. Brown, shot clock down to seven. Brown, step back. He's going to fire. It's on its way. Hits the iron hard. No good. Offensive rebound back to Brown. Fresh shot clock as it goes into the hands of Lustig. Great defense out of both these teams right now. Lustig spins through the double team. Attacks. He gets it in the foul. Anthony Peoples Jr. with the basket and the foul.
Anthony had a size advantage there and did a great job. Nice spin move. Got to the bucket.
So Anthony Peoples Jr., a 6'9" sophomore for the Warriors. And he will shoot one. Chance at a three-point play. This will be the Warriors' first free throw attempt of the evening. As the Royals leading by two over the Warriors. First round of the NAIA National Tournament. Free throw attempt number one and one only is up and in for Peoples. Anthony Peoples Jr., 5 points. He is the leading scorer for the Warriors. As they trail by one, he has half their points right now. And here come the Royals into the offensive zone and an offensive moving screen.
There's that question mark again. It was real obvious.
Sage Siamu will pick up the moving screen. He got the feet moving.
What did I do? You fouled.
Warriors back the other way after the foul. The Royals could get in a little foul trouble here. Five team fouls right now. Warriors with the basketball trailing by one. Offensive side, Boykins. Boykins picks up his dribble, fires it into the paint. And we're going to get a whistle and a foul. Carter got quick hands in there, and Carter is going to pick up the personal. Little shove call on the inside.
A lot of fouls for not even have a full 10 minutes and a half.
Yeah, next one will put the Warriors into the bonus. And that could be a big deal here in this opening half of play. As we approach the midway point of the first half, Warriors try to bring it in. They lob it all the way up top to Peoples. Peoples hands it off there to Lustig. Lustig leaves it for Boykins. Around left side, long range three. That's money for Jaden Bradley. Bradley knocks down the three, his first points of the evening. And the Warriors grab the lead, 13-11.
Is that their first lead?
That's their first lead.
First lead.
So back the other way, Royals going to go four wide. Pass up top into the high post. Pull up jump shot. That one goes wide left. Warriors with a rebound. LC looking to bring it into the offensive zone. They do so. Lustig to the right wing. Three-point shot is up and in for Jaden Bradley. Bradley knocks down back-to-back threes. 9:26 left to play in the first half. And the Warriors go up 16-11. And it looks like we have a timeout on the floor, JT. So with it, we'll take one as well. Lewis Clark State leading Hope International 16-11. We're back after this one-minute timeout. Hey, welcome back here once again to Butte, Montana. First round of the NAIA National Tournament as the Warriors of Lewis Clark State just grabbed their first lead a few moments ago. And they are up over Hope International 16-11 with 9:26 left to play here in this opening half. Game one of our doubleheader here on a Friday night in Butte. As Hope International into the offensive zone. Back into the ball game is Ramirez after rolling an ankle. Ramirez inside to see his shot no good. Huge offensive rebound by Siamu. Siamu back out to Shores. Shores to Siamu. And Siamu picks up his dribble, fires it back right side to Shores outside the arc. Shores through the paint, lost his footing. C on the baseline, shot no good. That one's going to go out of play and remain Hope International basketball, but only three on the shot clock.
Nice block by Stockton.
Well, I'll tell you, the Warriors have settled in defensively.
Yes, they have, and offensively.
Truly, yeah.
They're pushing the ball, but they're running their stuff, and they're getting good looks, and they're getting inside.
And shot is up and out for Ramirez. Here come the Warriors in transition. Lustig. Lustig outside the arc. Moves up toward the top of the horn. Passes left side to Bradley. Bradley. Stockton. Stockton with the right hand into the paint. Fires it down to the bottom right corner to Lustig. Lustig looking on the interior. Feeds it down on the inside to Hamilton. Hamilton fights his way to the rack. Boy, he had a tight, tight angle, and Alton is able to make it. That's a big-time shot.
Use the glass, baby.
8:20 left to play here in the first half. The Warriors go up by 7. And Hope International wants a short timeout. We'll go ahead and keep it here. Again, thanks for joining us here on Digger Vision. Game one of a doubleheader here for the first round of the NAIA National Tournament. And, boy, it's amazing. You look at the Royals and Hope International. They came out on fire early, knocked down their first couple shots. But, boy, now the Warriors have settled in, and they are controlling tempo on both sides of the floor.
And they're getting the ball inside down on the block and getting lots of good looks from the outside and penetration. And you tell me what's going on over here with Hope International. It's simple. How many times have they been to the free throw line?
Hope International has been to the free throw line once.
Yes, and so how many free throws did they shoot during the season? So they're not attacking the basket.
Yep, great point. And the other side of that is... If they get one more foul, they're going to put Lewis Clark State at the foul line for a while. They've done a pretty good job not sending them to the line here over the last couple minutes, but they're sitting with 16 fouls, and there is a lot of basketball yet to be played. So back into the offensive side is Hope International with it. Royals down to the bottom right corner. Williams moves it up top to Shores. Shores around a high screen. He's going to fire the three from the right elbow. No good. Huge rebound the other way comes Lustig. Rifle pass in the corner. Wide open three. That one hits the iron. No good. And that's going to go out of bounds and be Royal basketball. Boy, the Warriors have had some open looks from downtown. They're 1 of 7 from the three-point line.
Yeah, neither one of these teams great three-point shooting teams. They're get to the free throw line, penetrate, get the short game going.
Hope International around screen. Bounce pass goes into the high post as they feed it in there to Ramirez. Ramirez out of the right wing. Now it comes near side to C. Warriors showing man-to-man. Long-range three by C is up and out. No good. Warriors grab the rebound. LC up 18-11.
Yeah, Warriors doing a great job of controlling the defensive boards.
7:28 left to play in the first half. Warriors really putting things together nicely here in the first half. They feed it down to the block. Hamilton has his pocket picked, and the Royals will come the other way off the steal. Quickness again. Shores drives through the paint down on the baseline as he feeds it inside to Williams. Williams back up top to Ramirez. Again, Ramirez went to the bench after rolling an ankle for a moment. Bottom right corner, three-point shot rattles out, but an offensive rebound. Skyhook, second attempt, no good. And the Warriors the other way. That thing went halfway down the rim. 6:50 left to play in the first half.
Some days the good Lord isn't on your side.
Oh, joke. Lustig. Moves it up top to Bradley. Bradley step back, fires. Three ball is money. Jaden Bradley has three threes for the Warriors. He has the leading scorer on the floor with 9 points. And just like that, LC State goes up 21-11 over Hope International. The Royals with a basketball into the high post. They feed it on the inside to Williams. They need a basket here to try and get things rolling down. Pass left wing around a screen. They'll move it back out, spinning. Shores, Ramirez, shot clock down to 5. Pass on the right side to C. C, ball knocked away. Boy, that's a big-time play by Quentin Rayner.
That's an easy bucket if he doesn't get around him.
He beat him to that first step, and somehow Rayner caught him and knocked it out of play.
Well, their guards are extremely quick and great hands.
My goodness.
So we'll see what kind of look they get with 2 seconds on the shot clock.
So, again, thanks for joining us here. As back out here, pass in the corner. Three-point shot is up at the horn, and knocking that one down is Siamu.
Great usage of the screens to get himself open.
Siamu gets it right at the buzzer, just inside the arc, a two-point shot. Stockton moving left, passes left to Brown. Brown moves it up top to Rayner. Rayner on the right side to Stockton. Stockton wants the baseline, bounce pass. Moves it around, wide open three. That one off the front of the rim, no good. Royals basketball. So the first miss by Jaden Bradley. Big sigh of relief from the Royals as they come the other way. Royals looking to get something moving here on the offensive side. Pass up top is Felix. Felix moves it out on that right wing to Carter. Carter, he goes to Ramirez, back to Carter. And Ramirez going to put his heel out of play. That's a costly turnover. Gavin Ramirez gets the pass on the far right wing, and his heel is out of bounds, and the turnover will go to the Warriors. Boy, it was interesting in warm-ups, and even as it started, the Royals had so much pop in their step and so much energy, and boy, right now they look really flat on the floor, JT.
Well, I don't think they look as flat as they're not attacking the basket, and that's their MO. Let's go to the free throw line. They're not doing a good job of that.
Warriors baseline. Stockton gets it underneath. Great pass on the inside to Boykins, and Boykins finishes. Gordon Boykins rolls it in. The Warriors lead 23-13. Lead back out to 10. Matching their biggest lead of the night. Near side. Once again, a 10-point lead here for the Warriors. Ball's knocked out, goes out of play. And that will remain Royal Basketball.
They have studied this offense, and they understand what Hope understands. Lewis Clark understands what Hope's trying to run, and they're taking a lot of that stuff away, got their hands in there, they're touching balls.
And we have a timeout on the floor. 4:38 left to play here in the first half. The Warriors of Lewis Clark State leading the Royals out of Hope International 23-13. We'll take a break. We're back here after this 1 minute timeout.
Dude, Hudson, your new man cave is sweet.
Come watch the game.
Dude, they're gonna score.
Man cave, lady lounges, whatever you call them, Steele's Furniture has exactly what you need to make your room come to life. Shop our man cave showroom today for ideas to upgrade your bar set, fireplace, TV, recliner, furniture set, and refrigerator. Steele's Furniture, making man caves happen for 87 years.
.438 left to play here in the first half. The Warriors of Lewis Clark State up over the Royals 23-13. Lewis Clark State shooting 43% from the floor. And Hope International right now at 22%. As the Royals trying to get something moving here in the offensive zone. Lob pass comes all the way out. Tracked down here on the near side by Shores. Siamu to Shores. Shores goes right side to Ramirez. Back to Shores. Ball movement around the screen, stepping inside the arc. Shot clock down to three. Shores' shot is up and in. Boy, that's a great shot by Jalen Shores.
Over the top of the big.
He got some air under that bad boy.
Had to.
4:15 left to play here in the first half. The Warriors lead by eight. Pass out of the right side. Stockton. Stockton drives. Scoop shot to the rack, and he gets it.
So the guy's a true point guard. He's made some great passes here tonight. But that's you got to get in the scoring column. That was a nice shot.
Driving into the paints, pass through the middle. They'll loop it out of the right wing. Long range three comes up short, drifts into the corner. That one's going to go out of play, and it will go back to the Warriors. Good passing by Hope International that time. They're getting some decent looks, just aren't getting anything down.
Well, they aren't. They aren't attacking the rim, and obviously they've been scouted so well. Lewis Clark is really moving their feet and taking that stuff away. But this team scores a lot of points from that line. They're not getting any here today.
Around a screen, driving. Pass goes out on the left side to Boykins. Boykins from downtown, and he knocks it home. Gordon Boykins has 5 points. And the Warriors stretch their lead out to 13, the biggest of the first half.
The guard play has been exceptional for RLC.
Boy, Royals came out, led the first 6-7 minutes. And the Warriors started to reel them in, grab their first lead at the midway point of this first half. And now the Royals trying to recover. Ramirez gets it. Pass comes up top. Goes out on the far left side. Little head fake out there by Grant C. His pass on the inside is tipped and taken away. Getting a hand on it was Brown. He'll go across to Stockton. Stockton now to Bradley. Bradley on the inside to Stockton. He'll pick up his dribble. Needs help. As he'll get it off there to Bradley. Bradley. He's had the hot hand here early. Shot off the iron, no good, and C is going to be called with a foul. So Grant C will pick up his second personal. And that will put the Warriors at the line, and Jaden Bradley will step up. He has 9 points so far today. He averages 15 a game for the Warriors. As I mentioned in the pregame, he was the newcomer of the year in the Cascade Conference.
He's just a freshman.
Senior.
He's a senior.
Transfer.
Oh, he transferred.
Yep.
Got a nil deal.
I think they have the freshman of the year, too. So that's not a bad little gig there. So we do have a timeout on the floor. 2:52 left to play here in the first half. Looks like it's a short timeout. We'll go ahead and keep it here as the Warriors lead by 14. Hope International came out. It really felt like the Royals had momentum. They were controlling the tempo. They had the game they wanted for the first 8 minutes, and then what kind of rug was pulled out from underneath him, JT?
You know, I didn't think either one of them shot. It was 6-2 forever.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, LC got a lot more comfortable about what they're doing, and I think Hope has taken themselves out of what is their success pattern, and I'm going back to the free throw line. They've shot one free throw. This team shot over 500 free throws this year.
500 and makes?
78%. 500
yeah.
makes.
Yeah.
That's what I meant to say, makes. And 78% from the line. They're not getting there, and LC did their film work because they are taking all that away from them.
So Jaden Bradley at the line, shooting one more. He's the leading scorer on the floor right now. He has 10. And his second free throw attempt is up and in. Jaden Bradley has 11 points on the day for the Warriors. And they are now doubling up. The Royals out of Hope International, 30-15 our score.
You know, another thing, one of the big things in basketball is your matchup at guard. And LC is every bit as quick as Hope's guards are.
Royals as right side. Ramirez gets it off. Shot no good. Tipped out. Great hustle to keep that ball alive by Williams. Pass goes out to the right side to Shores. Shores, three-point shot, no good. Rebound controlled offensively in traffic, heavy pressure. And we're going to get a whistle and a stoppage of play. And we're going to get a technical called against the Warriors as Gordon Boykins going to be called with a technical.
Well, Boykins went to the dance where the two bigs were tied up, and he started grabbing things. And
yeah, he got both hands on the basketball and was... And just never let go of it. And the official right there called him with a technical.
Yeah, he kind of jerked it away after the whistle.
Yeah. So that will be against Boykins.
Do I think it's a good technical? No. No, in the heat of the battle, they're going to do stuff like that. It wasn't anything that was going to hurt anybody. He just wanted the basketball.
2:33 left to play here in this first half. The Warriors leading 30-15. And actually, it looks like the officials are now going to eyeball it on our replay. Well, no, they're not looking at the replay. They're just talking to the book and the clock here. So a dead ball technical foul against Boykins. And that will put Williams at the line. Tristan Williams has shot the only two free throws for Hope International so far today. And Williams will shoot the technical here. That one rims out no good. One more for Tristan Williams. Lewis Clark State leading 30-15. And Williams gets one of two. As teams come out here, and we'll get rolling. So they pull Boykins. He's chatting with the officials, or not with the officials, excuse me, with the coaching staff over there.
Let's see what play three is.
And the Royals inbound left side. Pass comes in to Ramirez. Moves it around the arc right side. Christopher drives. He's going to attack the rim.
Yep.
Puts it up no good, but we're going to get a whistle and a stoppage right underneath the basket.
2-3, 17 and a half minutes into this. That's the first real attack they've had at the rim. That's what got them here.
So the personal foul is going to go to Davian Brown. And at the foul line, going to be Caleb Christopher. So the Royals will go to the foul line here. As you mentioned, really the first attack of the basket here in this first half.
The first strong attack.
Free throw attempt is up and in. So Christopher gets his first down. Warriors leading 30-17. Again, thanks for joining us here as we make our way through a Friday evening. And at the foul line for number two is Christopher. Takes his time, shots on its way and good. So the Royals are 5 of 6 from the foul line, but they have dug themselves a hole here in the first half. The Warriors' defense has really put on a clinic here for the last 15 minutes. And Lewis Clark State leading 30-18. Pass on the left side, Brown. Brown feeds it across, Stockton to Lustig. Lustig behind the back, lost the handle on it, and we're gonna get a whistle and a foul. Lustig just put too much on it, tried to get back to it, and he's going to be called with a foul. That's John's second personal.
You know, Lustig's done a nice job on the defensive boards here, and he's not the quickest player in the world, but he's so in control. Does a great job of getting rid of the ball when they're breaking.
2:11 left to play here in the first half. The Warriors leading 30-18. Again, thanks for joining us here on Digger Vision. It is game one of our doubleheader here at the Hyper. As the Royals take it on the Warriors, game two has Montana Tech and Wayland Baptist. That one scheduled for a 7 o'clock start. And of course, we'll have that one for you as well. The Royals, top of the horn, looking right, handoff as it goes there to Murray. Murray back to his right side. K Kicks it across to Shores. Shores wants the entry, gets it inside to Ramirez. Double team. Nice pass through the paint. Shot is up and in by Siamu.
Good things happen when you hit that post.
So Sage gets his second field goal. The Warriors lead by 10. Royals looking to get a stop here and trim it down to single digits. Pass across, almost out of bounds. Bradley able to track it down. Bradley left side, Rayner. Rayner looking on the interior. Bounce pass into the corner to Brown. Brown moving up toward the top. Kicks it across, far right side. Bradley fires. Bradley shot short. And here come the Royals in transition. Shores, 1:15 left to play. Pass taken away. Stolen by Brown. He puts on the brakes, needs help, gets it rid of it. Three-point shot, no good. Rimmed out for Rayner. The Warriors right now are 5 of 17 from the three-point line.
And I don't like that shot off the steal.
Royals with the basketball. 55 seconds remaining here in the first half. Warriors by 10. Backdoor cut. Boy, what a steal that time by Stockton. Read it like a book. Down the floor, pass down to the bottom left corner, Rayner. Rayner up top to Stockton. Three ball, no good. Rebound tipped out, and that is Royal basketball. A 10-point lead for the Warriors. 32 on the game clock, shot clock at 20. There's about a 10-second differential. And the Royals setting things up. Pass here on the near side. As Shores, Ramirez, three ball, comes up short. Defensive rebound, Warriors.
Timeout, they want one.
Warriors will call a timeout. 16 seconds left to play here in the first half. The Warriors lead by 10. As NAIA National Tournament, first round action here in Butte, Montana. It's a short timeout. We'll go ahead and keep it here.
Timeout for a Princeton backdoor play right here.
Okay.
Get an easy bucket going into halftime.
10-point lead. And we'll see what happens here. Boy, an interesting ball game as, again, the Royals came out, felt like they were absolutely in control through the first 8 minutes or so. And then the Warriors woke up, their defense started to buckle down, and that created great things on the offensive side.
It absolutely did. And, you know, early, they had Hope had the opportunity to get a lead, but there were like three or four turnovers in succession, and they didn't take advantage of one of them. And you want to get that lead out front when you start early and try and hold it.
So the Warriors will inbound, 16 seconds remaining, as Davian Brown in the backcourt. Brown across midcourt, down to 10 seconds. Brown on the right side of the floor, out near midcourt, down to 7 seconds. Brown driving left side of the paint. He's going to go to the hole, shot blocked, whistle and a foul. And the personal going to go to Gavin Ramirez.
Coach will take that any day of the week.
So Ramirez picks up the personal. And that will put Davian Brown at the line here for the Warriors of Lewis Clark State. So Davian Brown, 3 points so far on the day. The Warriors are 3 of 3 from the foul line so far here in the first half. As we look to make our way into halftime, first is up and good for Davian Brown.
That play looked familiar. Days of Sindhu Diallo to beat Western on that. Remember we called
no
that play?
No joke.
Same play.
It really was, wasn't it?
No help, no hedge.
Go
to the bucket.
1-on-1. 11-point lead here for the Warriors. They led by as much as 13 not long ago. And the second is on its way and good. So Brown goes 2-of-2 from the foul line. The Warriors lead by a dozen. And Hope International looking to inbound. They get it in to C. C at midcourt, 1 second, fires at the horn and gets it. And they're going to count it. Well, the officials are going to chat it over here.
Probably going to take a look at it, but I think it was good.
One official said good. The other, I believe, said he immediately was like, let's go look at it.
Got to look at it.
Got to look at it. So 15 minutes remaining here as we get towards halftime. The Warriors lead 32-23. Why don't we do this? We'll take a break. We'll pay some bills. We'll come back. We'll see if it was a three-pointer or not, get you up to date on that and a whole lot more as we're back here at the half after this two-minute timeout.
coming right now. Still live feed?
Still live, okay.
No, Nick is coming right now.
Hey, we're back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. Round one of the NAIA National Tournament. Lewis Clark State leading Hope International 32-23. John Thatcher, real interesting opening 20 minutes of this ball game. Give us your take on kind of how things went down timeline-wise.
Well, I have a lot of admiration for Lewis and Clark, the way they came back and then extended that lead. They had a nice lead, and then we're trying to figure out if this three-pointer is good, which I'm saying it is and you're saying it isn't. And whoever is correct, the other person has to buy him a beer, and I don't drink.
I was going to say, neither do I.
I know.
How boring is that?
So that's boring.
Yep.
But I thought a well-played game. I thought both teams played defense real well. I didn't think Hope shot the ball well, and I don't know what their game plan was coming in. And you don't sit in the locker room thinking we got to shoot a lot of free throws. But for some reason, during the year, they shot a ton and made a ton of free throws. And yet today they've only shot like five or six, and two of those were a gift on a technical, so that doesn't count to me. They've got to go in and strategize a little bit. Also, I like the post entry to LC State. I think they've made some things happen out of that post entry, either getting some scores or making some great passes to wide open shooters. And I don't see Hope with much of an inside game.
Boy, it's so interesting the way this thing went, because it felt like Hope just had it in their back pocket for the first 8 minutes. Their offense, you know, they hit a couple shots. Neither team has really, I mean, other than Jaden Bradley. Bradley went on a tear, knocked down 3 three-pointers. But it feels like everybody is struggling to get any kind of consistency offensively. But there for a moment, it felt like Hope International was, you know, they were probably mid-30%. But the way their defense was controlling tempo, they were in control of that ball game. And then, boy, LC just kicked in the afterburners. And we talked a ton about defense early, and their defense has just been spectacular.
And, you know, that's a credit to Lewis and Clark, how their kids didn't let – I mean
with Hope International?
Yeah, yeah. Hope had – I'm sorry.
No, you're okay.
Hope had several steals early in the game, and I thought, oh, this quickness is going to make a difference, because everything I read about them, how great they are defensively, how many turnovers they force teams into. So the true story here is Hope is not having that kind of success here the last 12 minutes of the first half. They're going to have to go in and re-examine what they're doing, how they're going to play this, and change some things up.
Well, again, thanks for joining us here. Game one of the NAIA National Tournament, as we are here in Butte, Montana. Paul Panisco, John Thatcher here on Digger Vision. Let's take a break. We'll come back. We'll give you some numbers and set up that second game here in just a bit as well. We're back after this two-minute timeout.
We really wanted to expand our menu, really wanted to expand our clientele, offer the full bar, offer the grill and pub menu. I think everybody at First Montana did a really good job just walking us through it and explaining everything. Ryan really helps us by asking us personal questions. It makes a personal investment in what we're doing here. I think that matters more than just about anything, really. The personal relationship that you have and the personal attention that you get.
First Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
On the radio, it's almost all pre-recorded. long-running tradition in college mountains of being in that weightlifting.
He's doing good.
He's great at that part. And I honestly, it has come at the same clarity. It gets harder and harder. His predecessor.
Welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. We're at the half. The Warriors leading 32-20 as they took the three-point shot off of the board. Thank you.
You both owe me a beverage. I owe you a beer.
You both owe me a beverage.
Cheating.
And I apologize. I put on our social media. I actually put the other score on our social media. So
I thought they were up by nine when he made that.
They put it on the board, and then because it went 32-23. And they actually put it on the board, they removed it.
Okay.
So
that's where I got my nine from.
So the lead is 12.
You're happy that I was wrong, aren't you?
Of course I am.
That's a bad call by the official. Let me help you out here.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, again, thanks for joining us. We are one of 16 host sites across the country. Really, the only other one in the West is the College of Idaho. Our Carroll College from the Frontier Conference playing at the College of Idaho. Like nine Montana kids on that College of Idaho roster, of course, that we know of, including one we're very near and dear to here in Butte, Montana. The Frontier Conference, two members in this year. Talk about what were your feelings there as far as it, you know, we talked about it earlier where the Frontier Conference beats each other up so badly that, you know, it's going to be hard to get any more in. Dickinson State rejoining the Frontier Conference next year, and if we get some more, do you think that will really change the kind of dynamic on the Frontier Conference?
Absolutely. I can't think of anything worse than playing teams three or four times. You know, you have mental letdowns, and you got to change your game plan all the time. And how am I going to do this? We did this last time. They're going home and work against it. What are we going to do to change? There's only so much basketball you can learn out here. But I just don't like a schedule where you're playing teams three or four times in your comp. And you know, they get to the tournament, they play a fourth game against the same team. But it's competitive, and the bottom line is coach them up and win, and you get to do this kind of stuff.
That's it. You know, both these teams out here on the floor, the Royals and the Warriors, both come from very good conferences, very powerful conferences. You know, you look at the GSAC. Hope International finished 9-5 in the GSAC, getting an at-large bid, playing awfully well. And I believe the GSAC is one of, I think there are four conferences that have five members that made it, that got the bid into the national tournaments. And, of course, Hope International, one of those with the at-large bid. On the other side, the Warriors coming out of the Cascade. The top of that Cascade Conference, awfully good this year on the men's side.
Yeah, and they are usually every year. I don't think all 12 teams are real good, but again, you're talking about playing 24 of your game or 22 of your games against your conference, and then picking up a few non-conference games along the road. I don't know if it's good to be in a conference that big and you play some down teams and. I've always been a proponent. We can't get better if we don't play a team that's as good or better than us. So I don't really like that many teams in the conference.
Okay. Well,
Eight's perfect.
All right. Well, unfortunately, we're not to eight yet, the Frontier Conference, but hopefully we make it there soon. Let's take a look at our next game up. Wayland Baptist coming to town to take on Montana Tech in game two of our day here. First round matchup of the NAIA tournament. You and I have been lucky enough. We've called the Wayland Baptist women's team several times.
We have.
You know, we were lucky enough to call the NAIA tournament when it was in Billings, Montana. And the Flying Queens, I mean, if we want to talk about anybody being a perennial powerhouse, it's the Flying Queens.
They are.
We had the opportunity to call several of their games, but this will be the first time, for me anyway, that I've been able to call the men's side for Wayland Baptist.
Well, then I got to help you out a little bit. If it's your first time, it's definitely mine, because I'm not going to Texas.
You're like 114 years old, though, so, I mean, you could have done games with somebody else.
Well,
that's just
when we played at the Alamo in San Antonio. Yeah.
So that game is coming up next. Montana Tech winning the Frontier Conference regular season crown, winning the Frontier Conference tournament crown. And Wayland Baptist comes in with an at-large bid, and they certainly are ready to roll here coming out of Texas.
Yeah, and I'm a big believer you hit that 20 mark. I don't care where you finish in your conference. If you get 20 wins and are competitive in your conference, I think you should be in these playoffs. And I don't know how they do it or any of that business, but 20 wins is a lot.
It's
hard to get 20 wins.
Yep.
Yeah, it is. And so both these teams have gotten their 20-win seasons. I'd have to look at the record of everybody else. I don't know if there were any upsets in conferences that brought somebody to the tournament, but 20 wins earns you the right to get in. It's the same rule with the NCAA. If you got 20 wins, you got a good shot. If you got 25 wins, you're in. So doesn't take much for one game to separate you from the good and the bad.
That is no joke. Again, thanks for joining us here on Digger Vision as we're at the half. Lewis Clark State leading Hope International 32-20. We had discussed before we went, there was a three-point shot taken right at the buzzer, and we put it on our social medias and we talked about it. That made the score 32-23, but the officials went over, looked at the replay, and they waived that three-point shot, so our numbers going into the second half, the Warriors leading 32-20. If you are Hope International, you're the Royals, they came out on the floor with like 10 minutes on the clock. I mean, they did not spend hardly any time in the locker room at the half. What's important for them to get established early?
I don't have any clue what they talk. I'd still be hollering 6 minutes to 7 minutes into that halftime. I would, just chewing butt and pushing people.
You wouldn't have come up for air yet.
No, I wouldn't have. So I kind of have a concern about the conversation with Adam. I mean, these guys are great coaches, all of them, or they wouldn't be here. But to me, they didn't get into conversation about a lot of things because you can't run in. I mean, they didn't come out right at 10 minutes. They come in with like 10 minutes and 34 seconds on the clock. So I don't know what you say other than play better. Good luck, guys. So I have a concern for that short time. He knows his team. He knows what he's doing. He said a few things. But LC State spent a lot of time in that locker room. And halftime adjustments are the key to basketball, period.
Well,
period.
One of the things we talked about, you know, with this LC team is they've only got 9 guys on the roster. Let me take a look at the officials' numbers. Let's see how many they actually played. 3, 6, 8. So they've played 8 of their 9 they have on the roster right now. We talked about whether they were going to have enough gas in the gas tank, and I'll tell you, the effort they gave in that opening 20 minutes, you never would have guessed that was all they had on the bench. I mean, they got after it.
They really did. You know what? Hope got after it, too. They just didn't shoot the ball well.
Yes. Yeah, and honestly, as we look at those, we probably should give you the numbers here real quickly. Hope International shot 25% from the floor, 9% from the three-point line. They were 1 of 11 from downtown, 83% from the foul line. On the other side, Lewis Clark State shot 42% from the floor, 28% from the three-point line, and they were 5 of 5 from the free throw line. Individually for the Warriors, Bradley right now leads with 11, as Jaden Bradley, 11 points, 3 three-pointers. He's 2 of 2 from the foul line. Brown right now has 5 points for the Warriors. Stockton with 4. He's 2 of 3 from the floor. Hamilton has 2. Peoples and Boykins each have 5 points. Both are 2 of 2 from the floor. On the other side for Hope International, leading scorer is Carter Jr. Carter has 5 points. Siamu has 4. Shores, C. Ramirez each with 2. And Williams with 3 points on the day for Hope International so far in 20 minutes of play.
Well, you got a couple guys that are double-digit scorers that aren't even getting close, so they got to pick their game up.
Rebounding numbers are the same. 15 total rebounds for each team. Hope International, 6 turnovers. Warriors with 8. So Hope International into the offensive side. Royals looking to set things up. They feed it inside to Ramirez. Ramirez moves it out to C. C fires the 3, and he gets it.
Inside out, good things happen when you go into that block, and you got a great post player who can pass the basketball.
Again, remember, Hope International was 1 of 11 from the three-point line in the first half. They knocked down their first one here. Baseline, wraparound pass, three-point shot, rims out. Defensive rebound by the Royals. Here come the Royals in transition. Spinning up top with it is Carter. Carter drives the lane, shot, and he gets it. That's a great take by Giselle Carter.
That's the second time he's gotten that same move.
I have Carter with 7, and the Warriors lead by 7. Back the other way, Warriors driving, great take, shot won't go. Offensive rebound and back up by Hamilton.
Didn't see many of those first half either, offensive boards.
Alton Hamilton, freshman of the year in the Cascade. He had a good first half, running the lane quickly to the basket is Shores, and Shores converts. Just like that, both teams rolling.
A little bit of quickness on that play.
A little bit. Long range 3. It's up and out. No good for Brown. Shores gets it. And here we go the other way. Shores wide left as he goes out to Williams. And we're going to get a whistle and a foul. It's a block call as Tristan Williams slow to get up. Again, thanks for joining us. 6 o'clock here in Butte, Montana, as I have the hiccups, bear with me. 7-point lead for the Warriors, 34-27, just underway in the second half.
Do I need to do this for you?
Holy. Deep, yeah, please. Do you mind taking over for a little bit? That'd
deep,
be great.
Deep breath, take a drink of water.
Moly. Jeez, we were joking about you owing me a beverage, and now it sounds like I drank about 8 of them. Royals, pass to Ramirez. Awfully quiet first half for him. Driving a C. Nice pass in traffic. Right-handed shot won't go, but a whistle and a foul.
You got him.
Nice take that time by Jazelle Carter. He's really making his mark felt here as this second half gets started. Personal foul to Lustig. That's his third. That could be a costly one here for the Warriors.
I think Cope has come out with a lot more intensity, and if you look now how they're getting to the hoop is important.
Carter.
Maybe that coach just went in and said, let's play our game. We're not playing our game.
He showed him the one aggressive take to the basket and goes, that's it. I mean, this is our bread and butter. Yeah. This is what we do, and we're not doing it right now. And they have been very aggressive to the basket so far in the first 90 seconds of this second half. Remember, these two teams played earlier this year. The Royals taking down the Warriors back in November. That was on a neutral site floor in Caldwell. And an offensive rebound on the missed free throw. C has it up top. C, little ball fake, drives down the right side of the paint, puts it up, no good. Batted around, kicked out to the wing. 3-point shot is up and in for Carter.
I'm up.
Carter is feeling it right now. He has 11 points. And 6 of those coming here in this second half, and the Warriors will call a timeout.
Maybe they got off the bus because they were not that aggressive in the first half offensively.
No. We have a timeout on the floor, so with it, we'll take one, ladies and gentlemen. The Warriors up by 3. We're back after this 1-minute timeout.
Hey, Dave Brennan here with Case IH. One of the new options for model year 2024 is going to be an open spoke gauge wheel. That open spoke gauge wheel is going to be available on all 2000 series planters. That's going to help those growers in adverse conditions, whether they're muddy or high residue conditions, minimize that plugging in and around that gauge wheel area. For more information on this new offering of open spoke gauge wheels, visit your local Case IH dealer.
Hey, welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. First round of the men's NAIA National Tournament here on Digger Vision. Paul Panisco, John Thatcher, thanks for joining us throughout the country on the Digger Vision here on a Friday night in the Lewiston area down to California. Hopefully everyone will join the broadcast. Great game thus far. Right now, Hope International controlling here in this first several minutes of the second half. Driving hard to the baseline. Nice take. Shot up and in for Boykins.
Got the defender's hips turned and took it to the hoop.
Both teams hitting on a different level right now in this second half. Ramirez feeds it to the baseline and to the hands of Williams. Williams, great feed to C, and C will finish, and he'll get the foul as well.
Great entry pass. Tremendous entry pass. Nice cut.
C has 7 points. C, and I apologize for the reference for anyone that isn't familiar with the Frontier Conference, but tell me C isn't Harris Williams from the University of Providence.
He's his twin brother.
I mean, it's incredible. And they play the same. We have a young man by the name of Davian Harris Williams who plays for the University of Providence, who is just phenomenal. And C not only looks like him, but boy, their game is a whole lot alike.
Yeah, exactly.
Warriors across the timeline off the missed free throw. Here on the near side, pass goes to Bradley. Bradley hands it off. 3-point shot on the way. Front of the rim, no good. Huge, almost offensive rebound by Hamilton. Boy, I'm impressed with Hamilton in the post as a freshman. The other way, Royals looking to set it up. Williams down to the bottom right corner. Now it comes all the way up top, around a screen, spinning left, attacking the rack. We're going to get a whistle and a foul, and all of a sudden,
we're shooting free throws.
The Royals are playing their game here right now.
They are, because they did not do that. They did not execute like this in the first half.
What do you think? It's like a nerve situation. What do you attest that to? Do you think it was the other way where the Warriors just took them out of their game?
Well, sometimes you can be a coach and overemphasize. Let's run our stuff. Let's run our offense. No, what's got us here? Let's go. Continue to attack the basket and shoot some free throws.
Carter, 12 points on the day here. And he'll get the ball for attempt number two. He's 4 of 8 from the floor. Second free throw here is up and good. Carter having a heck of a second half here right now. He has 13 points, 8 of those already here in the second half. Around a screen, Stockton. Stockton hands it off right side to Rayner. Rayner around a screen, puts on the brakes, passes left. Moving right, top of the key. Pass goes down to Stockton. Stockton with the ball fake. They'll move it around the arc right wing. Looking for somewhere to go. Pass goes inside to Stockton. Great move on the baseline, and Stockton gets it up and in.
Yeah, Stockton, I like him as a point guard. He knows his role so well.
Smooth. Royals, 3 wide, 2 in the paint. Driving in, they'll move it up top to Ramirez. Again, very quiet so far for Ramirez. He rolled his ankle in the first half. C drives, steps through, rolls it up. It won't go. Tipped, and Stockton comes out with it.
Got a good look.
Cross town, half court. He'll pass it out wide left side as Bradley controls. About 4 minutes gone here in the second half. The Warriors lead by 3. Long range 3 won't go, but a whistle and a foul. And the personal is going to go against Carter. Carter pleading his case with the official. And that will put Jaden Bradley at the line. So again, the Warriors led by as much as 13 at one point. And I'll tell you, the Royals have come out firing here in this second half. At the foul line, first is up and good for Bradley. He'll shoot 3.
One way to break momentum is hit 3 free throws.
Hope International outscoring LC 15-7 here in the second half. Second shot is up and good. So Bradley 2 of 2 from the foul line, and he will shoot 1 more. 16-14 left to play here in this ball game. The winner will advance. Loser season is done. Bradley, 3 of 3. A 6-point lead here for the Warriors of Lewis Clark State, 41-35. Royals, Ramirez, strong take. Pass down underneath to Williams, back out short. Bounce pass to the right side, C. C wanted the baseline, and he will be fouled as calling, getting the block is going to be Jaden Bradley.
Basketball attack, attack the rim.
So Bradley will pick up his 3rd personal. That'll bring him out of the ball game for a minute. Lustig will come in with 3. So the Warriors a little foul trouble. 2 players with 3. Lustig and Bradley each.
That is big foul trouble this early in the game.
Yeah. Especially with how thin you are on the bench. Royals around a screen. Bounce pass on the interior. Gets it into Carter. Carter turning to his right. Gets past the defender. Shot blocked. Whistle and a foul.
Yeah, Stockton got him.
So that will go to Sam Stockton, picks up his 1st personal. A 6-point lead for the Warriors. And back to the foul line is Giselle Carter Jr. So the Royals shot 6 free throws in the first half, and they will go past that number with these 2 free throws here. Carter's 1st is up and out, no good.
Yeah, they've missed a few. I mean, this is 78% shooting team.
They're 66% right now. They're 8 of 12 from the free throw line. And Carter gets the ball for attempt number 2. Carter, shot is on its way. Back of the rim, no good. Almost an offensive rebound, but we're going to get a whistle and a foul. And I think it's going to go on Peoples. Yep, that's the case. So Peoples going to be called with a foul.
Wow.
And that will put the Royals. That's team foul number 7 already against the Warriors.
And this is a team of
one of the better free throw shooting teams in the country.
Until tonight, you just missed 2, so that they're not shooting a great percentage.
They're going to spend some quality time at the line for the rest of this one. 15:43 left to play in the ball game. The Warriors by 6. And the front half of the bonus hits the iron, but we're going to get a lane violation against the Royals, and that will go to the Warriors. So a lane violation on the missed free throw, and the Warriors with it. So the Warriors with 7 team fouls here in the second half. They lead 41-35. They led by as much as 13 twice.
They're putting hope into their game plan. They're not making free throws.
Warriors shooting 42% from the floor as they bring it into the offensive zone. Boykins. Boykins drives into the elbow, moves it up top. Long range three is up and out. And a defensive rebound brought in by Ramirez. Quickly down the floor to the right wing, controlling Carter. Carter feeds it into Ramirez. Ramirez left-handed into the paint, turns to his right, double team, out to the edge, C. C has a lane, C attacks. That one's gonna get knocked out of bounds. It will be Royal basketball. Just about 5 minutes gone here in the second half. The Warriors leading 41-35. And again, remember, the Royals dominated the first 8 minutes or so of the first half. We'll see if that kind of same thing plays out here in the second half. Royals driving, bounce pass to C. C feeds it down to the baseline. Ramirez turns and fires and gets it.
Yeah, for a guy, guys in double figures, he hasn't got many looks at the bucket.
I was just going to look. He's 2 of 6 from the floor. 4 points, and I don't remember that many shots. I was thinking maybe three.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Warriors inside, block call. As players go down, Ramirez is on the ground. He gets up off the floor. He's starting to look like he has the fight with Mike Tyson here this evening rather than later. He's gotten beat up here today. My goodness.
He has gotten beat up.
14:49 left to play here in the ball game. The Warriors of LC State lead by 4, 41-37. With a timeout, we'll take one. We're back here after this one-minute break.
Now's the time to get into Butte Auto and custom build your own ride just the way you want it. Choose from 9 brands and compare them all at one location. Don't wait. Take advantage of our VIP appointment or stay where you are and shop easily from ButteAuto.com. At Butte Auto, we believe in exceptional service and an easy buying process. Easy buying process. Contact one of our 4 dealerships and custom build your next ride at Butte Auto today.
Welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. First round of the NAIA National Tournament. We have another game coming up tonight. Montana Tech taking on Wayland Baptist. The winner of these two games will play tomorrow at 6 p.m. So the Warriors looking to bring it in, spreading it out, trying to find somewhere to go with it. Pass comes in left wing, Rayner. Rayner looking toward the baseline, feeds it down to Peoples. Peoples squares up. Bodies up, double team coming, kicks it out to the edge, now around the arc right side to Rayner. Rayner drives, floater to the basket is up and in.
Good body control, excellent shot.
It's a nice take by Rayner. That's his first field goal somehow. The other way, Shores, shot is blocked, goes into the corner, Warriors have it. Outlet across the floor to Lustig. Good transition defense again. Seems like we have said that a few times here today.
Yes.
Driving, Lustig comes up just short. Offensive rebound, slammed home by Peoples.
Great percentage shot, I like it.
Peoples has 7 points, the Warriors by 8. It's the biggest lead they've had here in a little while. C moves it out left side to Williams. Williams, great pass to Ramirez. They'll move it around the arc right side. 3-point shot up and in. Big time stroke by Carter. Boy, I'll tell you, he is on fire here in this second half. He has 11 points already this half.
Got to get him the ball then.
Pass goes out on the far right side. Boykins. Boykins moves it around the arc down to the bottom corner to Lustig. Lustig drives, puts it up off the glass and in.
I like Lustig as a player. He's really consistent.
7-point lead for the Warriors. Royals with the basketball. The winner will play tomorrow. Loser season is done. And that one, good defense as Gordon Boykins keeps pressure on the edge. Williams loses the dribble. It goes out of play. Montana Tech is going to get, or rather, excuse me, the Warriors of Lewis Clark State is going to get the basketball here.
Both these teams are earning every bucket they get. They're both playing extremely hard defense.
Looks like we're going to get a timeout on the floor here. 47-40, the Warriors of LC State up over the Royals out of Hope International. And it looks as though it is a full timeout. So with it, we'll take one as well. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll take a break. We're back after this 1 minute timeout.
watch the game. Dude, they're gonna score.
Man cave, lady lounges, whatever you call them, Steele's Furniture has exactly what you need to make your room come to life. Shop our Man Cave showroom today for ideas to upgrade your bar set, fireplace, TV, recliner, furniture set, and refrigerator. Steele's Furniture, making Man Caves happen for 87 years.
Hey, we're back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. Thanks for joining us on a Friday night. Game one of our doubleheader. First round of the NAIA Men's Tournament. This is one of 16 host sites around the nation. As the teams come back out after the timeout, it's interesting again, we're seeing a little bit of a change as Hope International really controlled the tempo early of this second half, and now the Warriors are starting to get the rubber on the road a little bit.
Well, you got to answer that. You got to make your runs if they make their runs. That's, basketball is a game of runs.
A 7-point lead for the Warriors. Full court pressure applied. Pass into Brown. Brown across to Stockton. Stockton in the backcourt. They set up screen. Now Stockton just dribbles into the offensive zone. Back to his left hand inside the arc. Lost his footing. He's in trouble. Whistle and a foul.
That's a good call.
As putting the hip to him that time was Cameron DeShiel. So DeShiel will pick up the personal. And that will be the Warriors here. Bounce pass comes into the hands of the big man in Hamilton. Hamilton clears it out. Good ball movement down to the baseline. Attacking the runner is Rayner. Rayner has 4 points. The Warriors go up 47-40.
Excellent ball movement.
13 minutes left to play here in the ball game. Moving it out. Hope International. The Royals with it. Royals backing up near midcourt. Moving right side to Shield. Rolls it into the high posts as he goes inside to Siamu. Siamu to Williams. Back out left side. They'll lob it into Williams. He grabs it. Fights his way to the rack. Shot no good. Good defensive pressure that time. As really Bradley never got out of position.
No, but he never got up to put it off the glass either. I don't know if he had full control.
12-18 left to play here in this ball game. A 9-point lead for the Warriors. Stockton drives, kicks it through the paint, attacking the rack. Shot is up and in as Bradley gets it.
LC settled in after the run by Hope.
That they did. The lead back out to 11. The Royals had cut it to 3. And just like the first half, the Royals came out on fire in the first 8 minutes. Now the Warriors have settled in, and they're back to their ball game right now.
Both teams really doing a real good job of taking care of the basketball. I don't know if they got turnover-wise, but both of them seem to be taking care of the basketball. Not a lot of offensive boards given up.
Both with 8 currently on each side. 8 turnovers for Hope, 8 for Lewis Clark State as well. Rebounds have been pretty much similar throughout this ball game. Hope with 22, Lewis Clark State with 20 right now. 9 offensive boards for Hope. That has turned into 6 second chance points. But how about this? Lewis and Clark has 5 offensive rebounds, 12 second chance points off of 5 boards.
That helps.
Oh. Oh. Yeah.
That helps.
That's a heck of a ratio.
There's your lead right there.
That's it. 5 offensive rebounds, good for 12 second chance points. Hello. Royals, pass comes in to Ramirez, just outside the arc, left wing. He'll move it up top to C. C, down the left side of the paint, stops, stutter step, puts up the floater and gets it, leaning to the basket.
Now Stockton did a good job defensively. He just sold the pump fake.
I like this young man and Grant C. He is an awfully fun player to watch. He's a junior. The other way, Rayner into the offensive zone. Moves it up top, 3-point shot, high arc, front of the rim, no good, but tipped up and in. Big time play by Hamilton.
Made that look easy.
Well, he did, didn't he? Young freshman, a 6'8" freshman. C with the ball fake, drives through traffic, goes to the rack, doesn't get it to go, but he does draw the foul. My goodness. 11:20 left to play here in the ball game. The Warriors leading 53-42. What a fun game we have been treated to thus far. Both these teams at large bids. Hope International coming out of the GSAC, powerful GSAC. And the Warriors of Lewis Clark States out of the Cascade Conference.
So, you know, I wasn't a very good student. I'm a PE major. What does GSAC stand
Golden
for?
State Athletic Conference. Hmm.
Must be a California team near San Francisco.
Nothing gets by you. Nothing. At the foul line, Grant C. gets his first. He has 10 points on the day.
This job would be boring if you didn't have me here with you.
Darn right it would. The two of us almost put together a normal human's brain.
Not even close.
Not even close. It was worth a shot. 10-point lead for the Warriors. Second shot by C is up and in. So C goes 2 of 2. Grant C, the 5'11 junior. He has 11 points. The Warriors by 9. Down the floor, Brown across the timeline. Brown goes to Lustig. Lustig down on the left wing to Stockton. Stockton moves it around the arc right side. Now, excuse me, up top to Boykins. I thought Boykins was going to get rid of it to Brown. Brown now with it. Cross to Stockton. Stockton into the paint. He's going to fire, and he knocks it down from 10.
Got too deep in the paint and separated from the defender. Nice job by Stockton.
Boy, you can't give him that kind of breathing room. He is going to make you pay. 10:50 left to play here in the ball game. Warriors by 7. Three-point shot on the way. Williams rattles out. No good. Rebound brought in by Lustig.
Lustig, that's got to be 4 or 5 rebounds for him.
Get you updated on that in a moment. He'll go the other way and fire from 14 and knocks it down.
Yeah, for some reason, the last two times down the court, Hope has lost their man. They're making short-range jumpers uncontested.
Lustig, 5 rebounds, JT. Through the middle, C lost it, picks it up, feeds it on the interior, shot blocked out of play. Come flying through is Gordon Boykins. And that one gets knocked out of play. 10:16 left to play here in the ball game. The play starting to fill in. We have a good crowd on hand, but we also have a tailgate outside. In my understanding, there are pork chops outside, JT.
They are.
And we're in here.
200 of them is what started off with.
C driving, C attacks, puts up the floater, doesn't hit their iron or the glass. And Boykins, or rather Lustig, is going to get the foul.
Late whistle. Yep. I think that's what has him confused.
Boy, that's a tough one. That's number 4 on Lustig here. So we were talking about a little foul trouble. Lustig has 4. Jaden Bradley has 3. As we approach the midway point here of the second half. 10:07 left to play here in this ball game. The Warriors by 13. And that foul line, Grant C knocks down another one. C is 3 of 4 from the foul line.
Next 3 to 4 minutes, Hope is going to have to make a run to get back in this, make this a game in the last 4 minutes of this period.
It's kind of strange how much the halves are mirroring each other, honestly.
They really are.
Second by C is up and in. The Royals came out and dominated the first 8 minutes of the first half, and then the Warriors put the pedal to the floor. And the second half started just that same way. We'll see if the Royals can change direction here. So we're going to get a whistle and a foul, and we're going to get a stoppage. 9:56 left to play here in this ball game. The Warriors of Lewis Clark State up by 11, 57-46 over Hope International. With a timeout on the floor, we'll take one. We're back after this 1 minute timeout.
It's more of a business anymore than it is riding. I'm booking, you know, travel, I'm booking athletes, large contracts, insurance, all kinds of different things. Ryan Nielsen, it doesn't get any better. I'm traveling busy all the time, and he'll help with all kinds of different things, from being in touch with my accountant to help finance some of the stuff that I need to get everything taken care of. The relationship there it's absolutely amazing.
First, Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Hey, welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. NAIA first round action here on a Friday night. This is the first game. We have another one coming up after this, as Montana Tech will take on Wayland Baptist. The two winners will play tomorrow at 6 p.m. and the winner will go to Kansas City. and continue in the round of 16. Warriors with the basketball. They are in control here over the last several minutes. Down into the paint, Peoples. Peoples attacks, pulls up high off the glass. No, tips his own shot in.
They don't use him as much as I would like to see him use him.
13-point lead for the Warriors. I'm not sure anybody would use him. Oh, what a shot by C. Grant C. Fallaway shot knocks it down. 15 points for C. Driving baseline take, wraparound shot, partially blocked. Stockton gets the offensive rebound of the putback.
There's why you recruit guards, right there.
Warriors shooting 50% for the ball game, and we're going to get an offensive. C put the shoulder down. You're going to get that call every time. He just leaned too far forward. Put the shoulder down, leaned into him.
What great defensive positioning and foot movement by the defender.
Yeah, Grant C., third personal. Team foul number 9. Warriors have 9, rather. Hope International with 5. For how long Hope has been in the bonus, they haven't taken advantage of it a whole lot.
No, they have not.
Stockton on the right side. Baseline, great pass to Peoples. Peoples underhand rolls it in. Peoples has 11. And the Warriors push their lead out to 15, the biggest lead of the day. Hope International drops it down on the inside. Ramirez kicks it out on the edge. Bounce pass up top. Williams for 3. It's up for the big time shot as Tristan Williams knocks it down. He has 6 points on the day.
Absolutely needed to hit that.
Hope is shooting 5 of 16 from downtown at 31%. Left side moving Brown. Brown through the paint in the corner. Stockton looks to answer, and he does. Sam Stockton has 13 points. Warriors back up by 15. Both teams kicking into a higher gear here. Hamilton, he's going to drive. Shot, actually Williams rather. Excuse me, Tristan Williams rolls it in with the left hand. He has 8 points. The lead now 13. My goodness. These two teams getting after it right now. As Hope International shooting 40%. Warriors up to 52% from the floor. Warrior basketball. Baseline, nice take, shot partially tipped. Ramirez got a piece of it. Back the other way comes Shores. Shores around the screen, kick out in the corner. C gonna fire the 3. That one goes long, and a huge rebound. Williams back to Shores. They wave the shot and a travel call on Shores. Wow, this thing has really gotten to another level right now. These guys are flying up and down the floor.
They're absolutely flying. There's so much quickness out here, but I'll tell you what, they've defended each other extremely well.
7:33 left to play here in the ball game. The Warriors up 66-53. The winner plays tomorrow at 6 p.m. And on the inbound, we're going to get a hold call, and that one's going to go on Shores. So Jalen Shores picks up the personal. Team foul number 6 on the Royals. So the next one will mean both teams are in the bonus. As the Warriors will look to inbound. Royals, full court pressure. 3 guys back. Warriors looking to bring it in. They do so. Comes into Hamilton. Hamilton across the timeline. Hamilton puts on the brakes, passes right side. Now holding on to it is Brown.
Pressure's coming.
Davian Brown out near midcourt. Brown, left hand, drives through the key. Gets a little separation, kicks it out right side to Stockton. Stockton into the paint. Lost the dribble, kicks it up. 3-point shot is off the iron, no good. On the rebound, we're going to get a whistle and a foul, and I believe it's going to go on Gavin Ramirez.
That it is. He's holding on to him.
I'll tell you, that is going to be Ramirez's 3rd personal. I said it before, but this Alton Hamilton as a freshman is impressive. He is playing awfully well.
Yeah. He's great, a great player.
His first is on its way, and he knocks down the front half of the bonus. Well, he's one you look at his frame. He's playing awfully strong at 6'8". You know, you get him in the weight room, pack on some pounds, he is going to be a monster over the next couple years here for the Warriors.
No question about it.
He was the freshman of the year in the Cascade Conference this past season. His 2nd money. But a big man that can shoot free throws nonetheless.
Yeah, I taught him everything he knows. No question about it.
15-point lead for the Warriors. Royals with the ball. Up top, pass goes left to Williams. Williams down to Ramirez, left corner. Gavin Ramirez back up top to C. C behind the back, trying to find a little lane to Shores. Shores leaves it. Williams drives the paint. Williams with the long arm. Shot no good. Offensive rebound of the putback. Great follow by Grant C. Jalen Shores. Shores has 6 points, and the lead is 13. 6:35 left to play here in the ball game. Warriors with it. What's the cutoff for getting this thing to single digits, JT?
Oh, probably the 3:30.
Okay,
Gordon, take 3:30.
Gordon Boykins attacks with the right hand and rolls it in. He has 9 points. The Warriors by 15 with 6:15 left to play. Big collision. They'll lob it in to C. C draws this quick double team, wraparound pass to Ramirez, and he'll finish.
C got away with a heck of a push there.
Yeah. 6 points for Gavin Ramirez. The lead is 13 for the Warriors. Hope does not bring the pressure that time. And reaching in, whistling a foul as Carter got a hand up high and right into the grill of Davian Brown.
Yeah. You got to be careful. You run away from the refs with the ball. You want to get a tee this late in the game.
You know, a physical ball game, a quick ball game, but we haven't had. It's been smooth. I mean, it's well officiated. Both teams playing within themselves. I mean, this has been an outstanding contest on both sides.
Man, I think they're both under 14 turnovers.
Yeah, 10 for Hope, 8 for LC State.
Yeah, that's good stuff.
And at the foul line, first for Brown is up and in.
Basically, this game has come down to shooting.
LC State shooting 51%, Hope at 40%. That number has climbed here, but yet they still find themselves down by 14. At the foul line, shot number 2 for Brown. And he makes both of those look pretty darn easy. Davian Brown with 7 points on the day, a 15-point lead for the Warriors. Around a screen, pull-up jumper from the foul line is up and out, no good. Huge rebound, Lustig.
There's my man. That's
it.
Number 6. That's a heck of a job he's done today.
That was a big rebound, strong rebound for that young man. Is back the other way, come the Warriors. 15-point lead. Driving, Brown, jump stop, kicks it out to Lustig. Lustig into the high post, pass almost behind his intended target. Warriors feed it into Peoples. Peoples standing on the arc, left wing. Peoples wants the baseline. Double team coming, shot clock. He tried to lob it underneath. It hit the iron, went out of bounds. It will remain LC basketball with 3 on the shot clock.
Yeah, Lustig got himself open. He was all alone down there. He just hit the rim.
5:21 left to play in the ball game. Substitution. And a substitution here is checking out of the ball game is going to be Caleb Christopher for the Royals. And for him is going to be Siamu.
Hope's got to make a run right now.
Christopher, a senior for the Royals. Warriors can't find an opening, so they call a timeout. 5:21 left to play here in the ball game. The Warriors lead by 15, 72-57. As the Royals had cut the lead to 3 here in the second half, and LC has put the pedal down to the floor. 5:21 left to play. We have a full timeout, so we'll take one. We're back after this.
Wanted to expand our menu, really wanted to expand our clientele, offer the full bar, offer the grill and pub menu. I think everybody at First Montana did a really good job just walking us through it and explaining everything. Ryan really helps us by asking us personal questions. It makes a personal investment in what we're doing here. I think that matters more than just about anything, really. The personal relationship that you have and the personal attention that you get.
First Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
I think there's more than one thing that makes Montana Tech unique.
I think it's incredible. It's special.
I've always kind of thrived off the adventure side of things and the unknown. There's no place I'd rather be going to school.
Montana Tech has provided me more than I ever could have expected.
Montana Tech made me a trailblazer.
Montana Tech made me a healer.
Montana Tech is my solution.
Be the solution. Visit Montana Tech today.
Hey, welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. First round of the NAIA National Tournament. 5:21 left to play here in this ball game. The Warriors up by 15, matching their biggest lead of the night.
Yeah, a real critical issue now is trading baskets. You don't want to trade baskets. You don't want to stop that clock for your LC.
Inbound pass comes bottom left corner to Rayner. Rayner moves it across right side to Brown. Brown to Lustig. Lustig into the paint. Picks up his dribble. Leaves it to Stockton. Stockton into the high post. Pass almost intercepted. Brown with it. Shot clock at 7. Brown right side of the key. Fighting to the glass. Shot goes up. Whistle and a foul. Hello. So a shove call is going to go on Grant C. I have Grant for 4. And that will put Brown at the line. I'm not sure we've talked enough about the game that Davian Brown has played here for LC State either, to be honest.
Yeah, he's been kind of quiet here for a couple minutes, but he's played really well. I just think LC's played really well today.
They have. Real comfortable, real within themselves.
Yeah, and I found my new favorite player, number 1 over there. He gets some things done.
John Lustig, the sophomore. Good. He's on the All-JT list.
He is. A blue-collar guy, man.
And Brown at the line, first one rattles out. That's his first miss from the free throw line today. He's 4 of 5. The Warriors are 12 of 13 from the free throw line. That's their first miss from the stripe.
Well, he's got to run sprints. He missed the big one.
So he'll get the ball for attempt number 2. A 15-point lead for the Warriors at the foul line. Second is up and in. So Brown gets 1 of 2. Brown has 8 points on the day. And with 5 minutes left to play here in the ball game, the Warriors up 73 to 57. Royals around a screen, driving C right to the rack with a right hand. Grant C has 17 points, 15 here in the second half. Brown slowly up toward midcourt, C on him defensively. Brown looking for help, leaves it off to Lustig. Lustig, far left wing, dribbles up toward the top of the horn, spins in traffic, takes it to the rack, and he gets it. John Lustig has 6 points all here in the second half. 4:30 left to play. Warriors by 16 with a right hand. Great take that time by Caleb Christopher.
Yeah, Stockton got him.
And Christopher gets the basket, and he will shoot 1. My goodness. We're getting people streaming in from the tailgate.
That's the first real excitement I've seen out of Hope's coach as far as taking the ball to hoop. He was excited because he got the bucket and the foul. He knows there's no games after today if you don't get out of here.
No joke. Hope International 21-9 on the year, 9-5 of the GSAC. Golden State Athletic Conference. At the line, Christopher, a chance at a 3-point play. We're going to get a lane violation here. I love that.
Yeah, Stockton's making the call.
And Boykins is looking back, but Boykins' right hand was on the floor in the key. So they'll set it up and shoot it one more time. Christopher shooting the free throw here. So Christopher, free throw attempt is good. So he gets another look at it, and he knocks that one down. 13-point lead for the Warriors. Warriors into the offensive side. Stockton running the point currently. 4:20 remaining here in the ball game. They lead by 15. They have stretched it out big time here as the Royals had cut it to a 3-point lead early in this second half.
Run some clock down. I don't know if that's the shot they want, but yeah, it is.
Big time three. Quentin Rayner knocks it down. He has 7 points on the day.
Made a liar out of me.
No joke. Pass up top goes to Ramirez. Ramirez on the right side to C. C feeds it into Ramirez. He's going to fight his way to the rack and get it in. Nice take by Gavin Ramirez. He has 8 points on the day. The Warriors up 78-64. Full court pressure. Driving through. And the pass is tipped, taken away. Royals. Royals get the steal through the paint. That one's going to be knocked out of play. And it will remain Royal basketball. My goodness, the intensity ratcheting up here. 3:34 left to play in this ball game. The Warriors up by 14.
LC has got to be a little patient, get the ball inbounds and clear out, let the guard get it up the floor. The clock management's real important now.
Royals will inbound Jalen Shores. Warriors will substitute. Hamilton will check in. Peoples will go out. Peoples, a sophomore. Alton Hamilton, a freshman for the Warriors. That's a scary combination for the next several years. Long range three is up, wide right, no good. Rebound tipped out, and that will be Warrior basketball. In the backcourt, whistling a foul. So they will foul Stockton.
Too early.
And we'll go the other way with 3:24 left to play here in the ball game. A 14-point lead for the Warriors.
Transition will be critical right now. Hope's going to have to shoot some threes if he hits these two free throws.
So Stockton at the line, shooting two here for the Warriors of Lewis Clark State. Sam Stockton has 13 points today. His first is up and good.
He's had a nice day. His shooting percentage is good. He's taking care of the basketball. He's made some great passes. Big day for Stockton.
Yeah, he's played awfully well. Second is up and in.
I think his dad had a little influence on his free throw shooting. He shoots just like his dad.
Okay. 16-point lead for the Warriors. Pull-up jumper from the foul line. No good for Shores. Stockton gets the rebound, and he's fouled again. Smart play by Stockton that time, like moving his body across, knowing he is going to make contact and getting the foul.
One-handed rebound. He snatched that right out of the air.
So Stockton at the line. And Stockton will shoot two more here for the Warriors. His first is up and good.
I really don't believe he's the guy you want to put to the line. For some reason, I just believe that.
So Stockton gets the ball for attempt number two. It's on its way. Front of the rim, no good. Rebound controlled by the Royals.
John Thatcher jinxed.
Christopher into the offensive zone. Christopher on the right wing. Pass up top. C. C around a screen right. Drives into the paint. Floater to the rack is up and in. Nice take as Grant C has 19 points and a 15-point lead for the Warriors. Again, this is the second time these two teams played this year, as the Royals won the first one, 74-71. Royals, great pass back the other way as they feed it inside to Boykins. Stockton to Boykins. Boykins has 11.
Their people thought they had the steal, and they didn't.
C for three, and he gets another one. Grant C has 22 points, and the Warriors lead 83-69.
We might have four or five players foul out of this thing right now with 2:37 left.
Yeah, with the amount of time remaining here. My goodness, again, thanks for joining us. People streaming in from our tailgate. This place is about to get real loud real fast. 2:37 remaining here in the ballgame. At the foul line, first is up and in for Jaden Bradley. Bradley has 17 points. I have Bradley 6 of 6 from the free throw line.
Bradley's played super.
Yeah, and the second is good. 18 points for Bradley. The Warriors lead 85-69. The winner will play tomorrow night at 6 p.m. against either Montana Tech or Wayland Baptists. Ramirez gets the pass, and he draws the foul, as getting a piece of him was Boykins.
Nice cut by Ramirez. Caught the defenders staring at the ball instead of ball and man, and he made a great cut.
So at the foul line, going to be Ramirez. Gavin Ramirez has 8 points. Both teams in the double bonus. First free throw here is up and good. 9 points for Gavin Ramirez. So Ramirez will get the ball for attempts number two. 2:30 remaining here in the ball game. First round of the NAIA National Tournaments. Again, thanks for joining us here on Digger Vision. We have game two of day one after this. Then we go to the second round tomorrow. Second free throw, no good. Big rebound by Bradley. Bradley looking to bring it down the floor. Trap coming. Bradley gets rid of it. Wide open is Hamilton. And Hamilton will hammer it home.
That's twice somebody missed coverage.
10 points on the day for Hamilton. The other way, pass is tipped out. Hamilton gets it to Stockton. And the Warriors with the basketball. They lead by 17 with 2 minutes left to play. A steal this time. As Shores gets the steal, he'll take it the other way and roll it in.
Yeah, you as a player got to be alert to what's going on the floor. Get rid of the ball, pass it.
1:59 left to play here in the ball game. The Warriors up 87-72. We have a short timeout, so we'll go ahead and keep it here. NAIA National Tournament here, day number one. And, boy, just an outstanding effort again, especially it's incredible. We talked about it multiple times already, but you look at that first half. Hope International dominates the first 8 minutes. Then the Warriors change momentum 100% and rickroll through the last 12 minutes. And the same thing here in the second half. Hope International comes out down by 13 at the half. They trim the lead to 3. And then the Warriors go, you know what? No, we're going to go ahead and stretch this bad boy out to 16, 17 points.
Well, as I said prior to the game, it's a game of runs, and you've got to answer anything that happens. Missed free throws for Hope here tonight, and which shocks me because they're such a good free throw shooting team.
So the Warriors lead by 15. Double team in the backcourt. So we're going to get a quick whistle and a foul. So as we mentioned earlier, we're going to have some players foul out here.
There goes one.
So as we get here, Giselle Carter Jr. is going to foul out of this ball game. That's his fifth. He'll go to the bench with 16 points. 1:57 remaining here in the ball game.
It's not a timeout. He's got a minute to put in a sub or he gets teed up.
So they do come out of the quick huddle. Again, this is the second time these two teams played. They played back, I believe it was, I want to say November 25th.
November 27th.
Thank you. Hope International won that one 74-71. That was in Caldwell, Idaho at a tournament hosted by the Yotes. And at the foul line, Rayner. His first rattles out, no good. Quentin Rayner. Boy, they haven't missed much from the foul line here as this one's gone on. They're 86%. They're 18 of 21. Rayner gets his second.
That'll win a lot of games for you.
No joke. 8 points for Rayner. 16-point lead for the Warriors. 3-point shot C, no good. Defensive rebound, Hamilton for the Warriors. Double team gets it away to Stockton. Stockton down the floor. That one goes over the head of his intended target. It goes out of bounds, and that will be a turnover to the Royals. 16-point lead here for the Warriors. But the clock definitely in favor of LC right now. Substitutions. Christopher will bring it into Grant C. C picks it up at midcourts. Wide lefts, little switch dribble into the paint. Hits the ground, travel call.
Nice slide.
Went down to the hip and slid across. The turnover will go to the Warriors. 1:38 left to play here in this ball game.
Yeah, I think they've just got to shoot a bunch of threes here if they even seen it happen before. It's rare, but.
So as we continue here, it looks like Hope International with the substitution as Josh Hardiman will see his first minutes. And again, if LC holds on to this, they'll play tomorrow at 6 p.m. against the winner of the Montana Tech Wayland Baptist game. That's coming up at 7 o'clock here on Digger Vision. We'll have it for you. Warriors, double team, ball stripped away, Ramirez. Ramirez to Shores. Shores puts up the shot. He gets the foul in the basket. Jalen Shores has 10.
That's why you have a point guard. That's why you have a point guard. So they turned it over because the point guard didn't have the ball. You don't want to foul. You want the clock to run. They foul. Kids make mistakes.
You're always learning. Always learning.
Always.
1:30 left to play here in this ball game. At the foul line, Shores shooting one, knocks it down. Shores has 11. The inbound right side, Rayner. Cross court to Brown. Brown down the floor. Stockton. He'll hold on to it. 1:20 left to play. He'll spin baseline, draws the foul.
It's a guy you want the free throw line.
That is the deal. And honestly, the way LC has shot the free throws as a team, right now, I don't think it matters. I mean, they're shooting 86%, and it's everybody, it feels like. And it looks like we're going to get a timeout here. Not sure what we have. We had fifth foul. So it was another fifth foul.
And a smart coach uses it as a timeout.
There you go.
Smart coaching.
So Gavin Ramirez picks up his fifth.
All the years I've coached, I just learned something. Right there.
That's, yeah, intelligent.
Did it twice.
Yeah. And he took advantage of it immediately both times. And honestly, the same goes, LC jumped out and reacted immediately and got out and talked to their guys as well.
Well, you got 1 minute. It's no different than a timeout. You got 1 minute.
And at the foul line, Stockton's first is up and in. And like I say, the only difference there is if you go over the minute, you're going to get a T. But you certainly have time to track things down and go. 17 points for Sam Stockton.
He's had a big day.
He has a great day. And somehow it's a quiet 17
yes.
points. Here come the Royals into the offensive zone. The Warriors making them pass it down, burning clock. Long range three comes up short. LC with a rebound. Brown in the backcourt. Trap coming. Brown Now he'll dribble it down the floor one-on-one. 1 minute left to play here in the ball game. Brown switches to his right hand out near midcourt, back to his left. Warriors by 15. They're looking to advance to round two tomorrow. 55 seconds remaining. Controlling Rayner. Rayner backs out 50 seconds. He'll pass down to the corner to Brown. Brown cross court. Three-point shot is on the way. Three-point shot is good for Jaden Bradley.
That did it.
Bradley has 21 points. 42 seconds remaining. The Warriors lead 93-75. The Warriors will advance to a round two matchup tomorrow at 6 p.m. And they'll get revenge on their November loss to these Royals. Nice take on the baseline by Kalen Murray. Murray rolls it up and in. Warriors have shot 55% today. They're 66% in the second half. They're going to win a lot of ball games shooting 66%.
You're going to win them all if you shoot 66%.
The Warriors are going to hold on to it. And the first game of round one here in Butte, Montana, will go to the Warriors of Lewis Clark State, 93-77. As the Warriors take down the Royals, let's take a quick timeout. We'll come back. We'll wrap this one up after a one-minute timeout.
It's more of a business anymore than it is riding. I'm booking, you know, travel, I'm booking athletes, large contracts, insurance, all kinds of different things. Ryan Nielsen, it doesn't get any better. I'm traveling busy all the time and he'll help with all kinds of different things, from being in touch with my accountant to help finance some of the stuff that I need to get everything taken care of. The relationship there is, it's absolutely amazing.
First, Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, equal housing.
Hey, welcome back here once again as we look to wrap this up. The Warriors will advance with a 93-77 win over Hope International as they shoot 55% to the ball game, 66% in the second half. Lewis Clark State led by Bradley with 21 points today. Bradley goes 7-of-7 from the foul line. Again, 21 points for Bradley here today. Stockton gets 18. Peoples with 11. Boykins with 11. Brown and Rayner each get 8. Lustig gets 6 points on the day for the Warriors out of LC State. 30 total rebounds for the Warriors and looks like 12 turnovers on the day. On the other side for Hope International, they're led by C with 22 points. Carter gets 16. Shores with 11. Ramirez with 9. Williams with 8. Looks like Christopher with 5. Siama with 4. And Murray with 2 points on the day for Hope International as they fall to the Warriors of Lewis Clark State, 93-77. The Warriors will advance to a round two matchup tomorrow at 6 p.m. against either Wayland Baptist or Montana Tech. And that is the next game coming up here on the broadcast.
And I'm looking forward to this one. I just want to say this. It was a game of runs, and it just so happened that Lewis and Clark State made more runs, and they shot the ball so well the second half. When you get a team that's hot, you struggle trying to beat them.
Once again, our final score, 93-77. The Warriors get the win over Hope International. We have game one in the books. The Digs taking on Wayland Baptist coming up next here on Digger Vision, ladies and gentlemen. We're back in a little while. Stay close.